Happy New Year! GSOPAO! You are watching USAGEN this week!
Akemashite, omedetou gozaimasu. Happy New Year and welcome to USAJ this week. Yamasakura is a computer simulation exercise and the U.S. Army's biggest bilateral exercise in Japan. Sergeant First Class Jeffrey Hilton of the 169th Fires Brigade Colorado National Guard produced these next three stories from the YS-57 exercise in Hokkaido.
The 169th Fires Brigade is participating in Yamasakura 57. We are currently in Camp Chitose, Japan, on the northern island of Hokkaido. The importance of this mission is to build bilateral relations between the United States and Japan to ensure that peace is maintained within this region of the world.
Now basically it's a pretty good coordinated effort between the staff in the sections. A lot of the personnel that work in here have deployed before and actually fired these munitions that we're actually simulating.
The benefit is the ability to sustain our technical task and become proficient at what we do in the military. These exercises allow us to do that, and really the benefit here is to work with the Northern Army.
US and Japan make good connection.
The 169th did a full blown out rock drill where they actually drew out the island on the drill hall floor. And the 138th participated via satellite, giving our input to join as one to make it a success.
There are several other elements of different National Guards who are involved in this warfighter exercise, specifically the 42nd ID, who is the primary maneuver force based out of New York, New York National Guard. In addition, there is 138th Fires Brigade based out of Kentucky, part of the Kentucky National Guard. And then, of course, us, 169th Fires Brigade of the Colorado National Guard.
And this year so far has been the best exercise as far as setting up, operational, and actually executing our mission.
More than 5,700 U.S. and Japan Ground Self-Defense Force troops are participating in Yamasakura 57. Captain Alvin Phillips explains the mission.
It's an opportunity for our soldiers to deploy to Japan to participate in Yamasakura 57. It's a bilateral command post exercise, but most important, it highlights a five-month closure for all the soldiers who have worked since August of this year to come here and put this thing together.
Being here has allowed me to have that larger perspective of how Guard and Reserve components fit in with active components. And it's been a great experience seeing where all the units in USERPAC are located and how they play a role in missions across the world.
My job is to track the enemy situation and work with the Japanese Self-Defense Force to find out where the enemy is going to be, where the enemy is, what they're going to do next. And we find out this information from all the other different components of the division that is working here with us in Japan.
I think things have been going very well. Things are going well. The soldiers are energized, they're pumped, and they're prepared to execute exactly what they trained for.
Yamasakura has been a great experience. I hope that we can continue to work with the Japanese people. It's a beautiful country. It's been a great experience.
We're preparing to go meet with a Japanese family and enjoy some of the culture and lifestyles of the Japanese. So my expectations are that we're going to actually have the opportunity to meet, sit down, perhaps eat dinner with, and exchange gifts with a Japanese family and learn a little bit about their culture and lifestyle.
I got selected to take part in a Japanese family home visit. It was a really neat experience. We went to a family in Chitose. They had prepared a big meal for us. It was absolutely incredible. It was a farm owner and his wife, and we went out to their garage, and there was kind of a barbecue pit in the middle of the garage. We cooked all the food on there, ate, had some sake, had some beer. It was really, really good time.
Three, two, one.
When we went to the Japanese family's home, we were escorted by an interpreter, and it was a great experience having him there because it kind of helped with that language barrier.
U.S. military enjoyed pounding steamed rice cake, rice. I looked very fun.
One of the neater things that we got to do was take steamed rice and put it in this big bowl and then started pounding on it with a hammer to turn it into kind of a gooey paste. The wife of the guy came back with soup, and that pounded rice was now in the soup, and it was delicious, kind of a marshmallowy texture.
Host family and U.S. military made a good connection. I hope U.S. and Japan make good connection in future.
I'm very happy.
One, two, three.